Perfectly portrayed here are the two primary aspects to my personality, Pantera and Unicorn. Hi, so I'm just gonna keep this ridiculous thing on because I look awesome and also rainbow. I want to talk about abandoning stories or story ideas with you. Earlier today, I was organizing my cupboard space, something that I have neglected to do in the 2.5 months that I have been living in this spot. And I came across this bag full of sentiments and things from my past, but what was also in this bag were story ideas. Let me show you. This was one of the original drafts of The Fifth Warrior. I say was because I destroyed it. It was handwritten. This is what I tore out of the book. I haven't read through all of this, but as far as I can see, I wrote up until chapter 8. There are a couple of reasons why I just want to be done with that. Firstly, I haven't read through that crap in like 10 years. The only reason why I have kept it is sentiment, and as it turns out, that draft of The Fifth Warrior doesn't actually mean that much to me anymore. This shitty little draft that I wrote when I was a teenager is just embarrassing now. Another reason is because it's not even a complete draft. I only got up until chapter 8. The Fifth Warrior was a very different story back then. It wasn't the same story at all, actually, now that I think about it. The main story arc of it was definitely there, but its progression was completely different, its focus was completely different, and there was a massive chunk of the story now missing from it. This is not a story that I am ever going to return to. I much prefer what The Fifth Warrior has become, and I don't even have to use that for reference. Now, of course, I'm going to read through it before I destroy it, because you never know, maybe there is a good idea left in there that I could incorporate into the Disincarnate series at some point in time, but I just really have no desire to keep that anymore. A couple of days ago, I was watching some videos on writing, and I saw one by Stephen King. I don't remember the details of this video too well, but I know that he was answering a question about whether or not writers should keep notebooks. And he said, I am paraphrasing here, just by the way, that he believes that notebooks are the best way for writers to immortalize their bad ideas. That phrase has a lot of weight to me now because that shitty original rendition of The Fifth Warrior is not the only story that I'm getting rid of today. This is a file full of story ideas that I haven't really sorted out in a couple of years. I just keep adding crap to it, and then it's left to gather dust. So I'm gonna go through it right now. The first one I'm actually gonna keep. These were notes that I made on the Knights of Nyarrodin in 2017, I think, for Camp NaNoWriMo. And since the Knights of Nyarrodin is a story that I am actually actively working on, I'm gonna hang on to this. The next one I'm actually also keeping because I am working on the story too. I wrote this in November or October, something like that, in 2018, last year. It's for my story called Long Short Drift. And now we have one that I'm going to destroy. This was a story that never really had a decent name. The idea behind this was going to be very generic, that two societies from two completely different worlds end up meeting, and the one society was like sort of medieval, and then the other society is our society with technology and human rights and stuff. I don't even know what was supposed to happen in this story, and I am putting myself to sleep even just thinking about this. The next one that I found, I'm not actually destroying, but I'm not keeping this story as I planned it initially. This is also from when I was maybe 16 or 17 years old. This is a story idea that I had called God Wielder. I'm not going to tell you too much about it because I'm going to reference this a little bit later in this video, but yeah, I'm going to keep this because I made a shitty little map of my fantasy world and I'm going to need this later. Likewise, this was a short story that I wrote called Morgoth and the Heart of Courage, but like Godwielder, I can't really tell you about it right now, so give me a second. Oh my god, my writing was terrible. This this was an idea for a graphic novel that I'm literally never ever going to create, so it didn't even have a name. This I'm keeping because these pages that are in this sleeve were the original diary pages for Rust Fever, so these really do have sentimental value to me, and even though I'm never going to use them again, I just don't have the heart to ever throw this away. This was a story idea that I started developing about a man who can literally never forget anything, and then I don't know what the point of the story was supposed to be, but the woman that he loves gets into an accident or something and forgets everything about her own life, and he retells it to her. That actually sounds like a really cool story idea, but you know what? It's too much to think about. I don't want to research human memory to write a believable story about that. I don't care about these characters. I never cared about these characters. And although this idea was cool at the time, it's just not something that I'm ever going to invest in, so here's one that I'm keeping because I am invested in this story. It's under the working title The Halloween Boys. It tells the story of a set of brothers who are cursed through their bloodline. This story I'm not quite sure I want to get rid of, but I don't know if I'm ever going to develop it. It is a story about a dystopian world after a nuclear war, and it involves some aliens, and humans are enslaved by them. And this was the first short story that I ever wrote for a writing competition, which is extremely pretentious, and I don't give a fuck about it anymore. I am not showing you the artwork of this, okay, but this is a graphic novel idea that I actually do want to develop, so this is staying. This paper has a list of every single story idea I have ever had, whether I've worked on it or not. Then there's a story called Tabitha's Time Machine, which at the time I thought was going to be very cute and sweet and romantic and magical and charming. I don't even remember what the point of the story was going to be. Oh, then there's Slayer's Blood. This is from a time before vampires were lame. Slayer's Blood, I'm not inclined to give the plot away for because it's a pretty cool and original idea. But there's a problem with it. It has a massive plot hole that I cannot seem to fix. Like, I ran headfirst into a brick wall with that idea. Oh, then there's The Last of the Lost Souls, which is actually a prequel to the Disincarnate series. Ooh, I forgot about this idea. I had a story idea about a mass shooting. That one I really, really, really want to write, but I don't think I'm ready to yet, because obviously it's really sensitive subject matter, and I don't want to mess it up or get into trouble for it or hurt people. Then I listed a story called Deception. Do you think I know what deception is? Because I don't. Then there was a story that I came up with, Blind Man's Buff, and the plot of this story was supposed to be about a man who is blind. He can't see shit except for ghosts. There were also a million, billion, trillion plot holes in the story as well. And although it is one that is also pretty close to my soul, I'm not sure that I'm ever going to write it. So, I don't know, you guys can decide on that one. Do you want me to write it, or should I just give up on it? There was one that was just called Slavery. Oh, no, wait, I remember what story this was. The gist of it is that black people are enslaved because they are the only ones who have magic, and so out of fear and also just greed, white people enslave them until there is an uprising and they decide to fight for themselves. And then there was one more story that I completely forgot I came up with, which seems pretty cool now, but if I'm honest with myself, I'm probably never going to write it. The idea of it was that there are three women a mother and two sisters who are connected through magic and a parallel world. So now that I've filtered out the stories that I'm definitely letting go of, I'm left with six story ideas that I'm taking seriously, and six where I might get rid of them later, but I haven't quite let go of them yet. The six that I'm taking seriously are the Disincarnate series, which is six books on its own, actually, and also The Last of the Lost Souls, which is the prequel to the Disincarnate series. Then there's Resfeber. There is Long Short Drift, The Halloween Boys, the story about the brothers and the ancient curse, and also a story idea that I have called Gemma and the Warlords. I have described Gemma and the Warlords very briefly on my primary channel, but the thing about it is that it brings Morgoth and the Heart of Courage, the short story that I wrote, and Godwielder, the story idea that I had, back into what I'm trying to say. The thing is that with both Morgoth and the Heart of Courage and Godwielder, I loved the story ideas, but I hit a brick wall with both of them, and so I just never really put any more thought into them. When I started developing Gemma and the Warlords, however, its premise solved the plot holes or the gaps in both Morgoth and the Heart of Courage and Godwielder, and so what I've decided to do with that now is turn it into a trilogy. These three stories, which started off completely individual with no connections to each other at all, somehow, like magic, all fit into each other really, really well. So then, with the six that I'm kind of meh about, I need your help deciding, like I said. There's Slayer's Blood, Blind Man's Buff, the human race, the one about the aliens and the nuclear weapons, slavery, the one about the mass shooting, and the graphic novel that I'm not letting go of. Graphic novel idea, should I say. So that means that there are 12 works in progress, right? How do you prioritize which stories you pay attention to and which ones take the back seat? I lied. There's not 12 works in progress. There are 13, because yesterday I came up with another story idea, and I really, really want to write it. But obviously, in my life, The Fifth Warrior and Resfeber are supposed to take priority because I've already published them, and then I took them off the market, and I was meant to republish them this year, but I haven't even started with that yet, and there's just so much to do. Then the other problem is that with work and also having a life and sleeping, you know, I have very little time to work on my creative writing as it is. So, how do I divide that time between 13 different stories? Okay, technically seven, because six of them I'm not too sure about, but you know what I mean. Do you just go by which ones you're most excited to write about? Do you go by what's inspired? Do you go by deadlines that you've set for yourself? Like, how does it work for you? Also, tell me about story ideas that you have abandoned, if you're comfortable talking about that, or like, let me know why you decided to walk away from stories or give up on them. Like, what's the final straw for you? What makes you decide that a story is not worth writing anymore? There's just so much to talk about within this topic, because I think most of the time people think that writers just generate content, that we're content-generating machines, that we always have ideas for stories, but it's not always addressed that most of the time our ideas are just ideas, and they never actually take form. In all forms of art, I think that letting go opens up a lot of room for better ideas, for more exciting ideas, and it can also just, I don't know, nurture your motivation to work on the stories or the art that actually matters. So I'm going to try and live like that now. I would love to hear your thoughts, so please do comment down below, and I will see you some other time. That's all. Bye!